Okay, voila, finished painting. I actually painted this photo in an impressionist way onto this small canvas that is 25.25 centimeters. There's a full, I actually originally was only going to do a kind of a sketchy thing, but it just took off and I kept on banging on here until I just went into. It's still, of course, impressionist painted. It's not very, it's not hyper-realism or anything like that. So it's very, see the textures and stuff. So, yeah, but it was a nice experience. And I hope you enjoy the ride. Now, this is my studio. Here it is. This is my avocado plant. And, yeah. And yeah, I do hope that you can help me, but I really need that help. Give a thumbs up, leave a comment. It costs you nothing to give a thumbs up. You can also go to my Patreon and sign up for $1 or $5, and I will, or $15, and I will teach you how to paint if you want me to, or help you in any way. That's great support. And if you can, do me the favor, let my videos run, even if you don't look at them, because it helps me up my view time and stuff. But I of course prefer that you like them and that you actually do watch them for the right reasons. But anyway, anything helps, remember, thumbs up, leave comment, and I hope to see you in my next video. Yay. Yeah, a little thing, you also find chapters in description, so you can jump around to your different favorite chapters where I do different things and talk about different things. Okay, stay cool, keep painting, have fun. Okay, here we are, another project. It's going to be a very impressionist rendition with working with the light and dark and colors and stuff. I try to keep it very open and impressionist like. So, painting on this 25.25 centimeters frame, and I'm gonna do the sketch in real time so you can talk about painting, hopefully, and probably some other stuff too, which I always do, but you know, that's how I am. So, with this, welcome to landscape paint. Okay, I'm ready. Check, go. Good. Now, this is gonna be exciting, I think. There's a lot of shit happening here. So, what do I do? Where do I start in this mess? Look at all the branches, all the pieces all the things that happen, all the shines, all the different, you know, I just need to kind of decide where to start, because it's a very chaotic scene. I think I'm just gonna line up a little bit roughly here and kind of, you know, all these things are coming out like this, in here, out there, down all the way here, and then I have the light, there's light in between here too, stuff happening. Maybe I should paint this way, just touch like this and paint it kind of, it's like spotted, a little bit of spotted, what's that, there, yeah, something like this, yes. Something like that, anyway. Okay, and here, lights. mountain fence. Well, that's all the way over here, actually. So, which means that this one is out here. It's funny how I can actually be tricked. And you see. Here, some blue. Actually, artists who would be content with this, you know, oh yeah, that was cool. And it's kind of cool. So much vanity in art. So much bullshit. Yeah, there's a very orange up there. I took this with my Olympus digital camera, actually. And the digital camera at Olympus makes the colors very vivid. For some reason, I don't know why. Maybe it has to do with the colors Olympus are using. It's a nice camera. I've used it many years, actually. It's a nice camera. It's very vivid. So, and that will be about here, I guess. There, maybe. Yes. So much happening here. This probably be the most difficult one. It's hard to tell where to start in this because it's so chaotic. But I chose it, so I just have to live with it. Probably chose it because it is difficult, because there is a lot of stuff happening. Choosing stuff because of the challenge, I often do that. My arm is still killing me. Oh, shit. I wonder if it is a muscle I've just pulled or something. It isn't that painful, so if I took a little bit of a painkiller, it would probably just go away. Then again, I'm not into using too much. I'm going to be in severe pain until I start using some painkillers. I really don't like to screw up my intestines and stuff, but you know, if you're doing an exhibition and your arm starts to hurt, might be a time to evaluate your principles a little bit. But anyway, it's approximately, so I'm just gonna give it a basic hue here. I'll just fill in different. Now this has to be extremely bright. I can actually work with this and then go in after the fact and do the necessary adjustments. Okay, sorry about that. I went empty card and just continue where I let off. Luckily, I wasn't in one of my usual rants, so I guess we didn't actually lose anything. let me see here. So it's gonna be fun, I think. I need to concentrate a little bit better because I see that I shouldn't pour in as much paint in here, because this should stay down. What should actually be the thickest parts here is in between the branches here and in this extremely white piece here. That is what I should try to focus on. One, yes. Work. La ricresi. It's quite nice to these loose things that I'm doing here. Is really just so liberating in a way, to just to pour in the color like this. I if I would have accepted this when I was younger. Between there. It's funny, I'm under a lot of pressure right now to finish a lot of stuff, but I don't feel that stressed. So I'm procrastinating a lot. I am doing that, so that is also probably a sign that I am a little bit stressed, but it's not severe. It's not that I'm breaking up or anything. And maybe I'm just content, you know. I just see how far I get. It's not many days I have left, so just see how far I go. And just have to accept the result, no matter how it turns out. And maybe that's a good thing, to kind of accept one's own limitations a little bit and just do the best one can with the time on it. You can think like this: when you are stressed and you are out of, you should wish you had more time, and you have actually sketched stuff and it's already, they can only get better, you know. So with the time you have, you can, maybe you can't get all the way, but you can actually, at least for every hour, every day, that you paint, things get a little bit better. And that could be enough in itself, maybe. I don't know. Just an idea. Because, oh, it's not finished, there's so much to, well, work on it, and tomorrow will probably be a little bit more finished. Like, yeah, tomorrow I'm gonna work over figure painting, so I'm gonna just gonna start with that. I'm gonna paint as many hours as I need to get over the whole thing. And then I will try to get some other stuff done, if there are time spare. If not, I just do the other things the day after, and then slowly, incrementally, you just finish it. And that's what I want to do. That's how one should think, or you will get so stressed that it will be actually paralyzing, and that doesn't help anyone, you know. It doesn't help getting totally paralyzed and, oh my god, I'm not gonna be able to finish. No, it's pointless. Really pointless. And I have to structure myself, because I know what painting will take more time and what will take less time. Like these more rough landscapes here, they don't need to take that much time, because, well, they will take a few hours, but it's not like an advanced figure painting that I just want to become really nice. It's easier than that. kind of just how rough it is, you know. Just keep it open. Just hammer it in. Just let it, you know, evolve itself. You have these branches and stuff. There's so much happening. There's no way I will be able to sit there and draw every branch, every tree. But I will try to get a few things right. There's sunlight hitting some kind of branches over here. Yellow, boom. Right. Different places inside here. You have the branches going up like this. But that is also things I will put in when I'm just gonna get in the main things, and then I will add on top or inside on top or whatever you choose to call it. Like this. Maybe I should remove a little bit of corner here, so it's easier for me to add in a brush stroke without it becoming too dirtied up. Like this, because there's a little light there hitting that. Here too, light. And there's a lot of stuff happening. Just approximately. No. Kind of here. It's actually not that high. It's probably. See how loose and easy, when you get some skill or you get a little bit of capability of foresight, you can actually see into the future how things will kind of come into being. A nice thing to do. Okay. I went to silent, I guess. I went into thinking about other things. So I actually forgot that you were there. Wasn't that great? So you didn't have to listen to my rants all the time. Anyway, I'm just gonna do so much light that just pops up, but comes out of nowhere in a way. That's the funny thing about light, you know. You talk, where does light actually come from? You know, you turn on the, you turn it on and boom, there's the light. Where did the light come from? And that's the funny thing is that it's actually created the instant you turn on the switch. So the light wasn't there in the first place. It just comes into existence when you... And then after that, I guess it flies off in the speed of light forever. Wouldn't that mean that the universe should actually be filled up with light? Mm. That never actually goes away? Oh. Anyway, just a thought. I'm not a physicist. I can't answer that question. So... That's how it is, I guess. It doesn't look too bad. Take my mirror and have a look. Mirror. Yeah, I mean the proportion doesn't look too bad. Seems like I hit the jackpot there. I just have to kind of add in more. Just keep banging on and see what happens. I can actually feel that I do get more easily tired now when I paint. It is a bigger strain for my, still actually a bigger strain for my brain than it used. It's not that fluid, but it will become that because what I'm doing now is that I eat the right foods and do the right choices, and I just need to give the brain some time to basically repair all the damage and connect new neurons. And as you build your brain up again and you paint more and more and more, what happens is that the brain becomes fluent in it. It is, actually they say that if you talk about something a lot, you get better at it. So me making these videos makes me more conscious of what I'm actually doing. Because I usually don't talk much about painting with people. I don't have that many artist friends. Sometimes I talk with people from YouTube or Patreon or whatever. But I usually don't speak much about painting, except from in my videos. My friends are normal people. Most of them aren't artists. They are doing other stuff. So, and of course, it's like a friend of mine said once, he's an author, and he said, the more I write, the less interested I am in talking about it, because it is something he does all day, you know, it's every time, day, and in the end, maybe in your spare time, you just want to have a respite from it, you know. And to talk about painting on a high level also demand that you have friends that understand what that means. And there's not many people who understand what painting is actually about, because it isn't about a motif and stuff, it is about the paint, the beauty of the brushwork, the sweetness of just creating, and the flow, that is what it's all about. Anyway, I'm gonna take a break and I'm gonna do some more work on it, and then I'm gonna do actually another one after this too. It's more landscape, so it's an easier thing to do than this. And I think actually I kind of hit something here. I got it almost right, so that's good. Okay, I'm gonna focus a little bit more. Nah, can I stand like this? Maybe I should do like this. Get a little bit closer. Like this. So you can see better, maybe. Nah, shit though. That's good actually, I think. So you can see both of it. Anyway. So, here, now I will just do a little bit more, not so much, because it can actually just surface dry, maybe, just gonna add in some, no, I just have to keep it loose. What I'm going to do, I put it actually over the oven, but I think I'm gonna hang these so they don't dry totally, so they just get sticky and it's easier for me to paint over. So many things happening here, so yeah, branches coming in and out. Coming down here, the light on them, it's wrong color actually. No. It's just approximately. Everything here will be changed anyway, so it doesn't matter that much. Things are totally open, and they have to be. Just gonna such a chaos. It's funny how my voice just, you know, voice just go numb, and it kind of shuts down when I start doing this. Just goes numb. Not numb, but silent. When you start, really start to focus, really start to concentrate. I guess that is why I fell in love with painting too, because silences my hyperactive brain. You should try it if you are hyperactive. Have some ADHD issues. Painting is perfect. It's just the thing to do, in my opinion. It kind of slows you down, focuses you. It's beautiful. Sincerely beautiful. Did place that one. Kind of knew it. Kind of up here. Comes in here, goes down like this. Comes in here, doesn't, goes in here, goes. Also wrong. It doesn't matter. That is such, so nice to know, to just let it grow, let it just shape itself in a way. Okay, again I got I went south with the place in the current, so that is why it stopped, and maybe that is a sign to me from beyond or something, which I don't believe in. Let's see here. Just gonna do some adjustments and then I'm gonna quit this thing for now. Like this. Like this, like that. So much happening here. There is so much happening everywhere. See. Just have to repeat some of the chaos. Try to. That is the same thing as I was talking about in another video, or many videos. You know how branches are growing? They are growing in the gyldne snitt, the golden snitt, or whatever you call it, golden. So I kind of have to follow some laws, you know, despite. There are certain things that just isn't possible, but you know, just concentrate about getting it approximately right. Yeah, because this one is there, it's not there, so. There's a nice shadow on the wall here too, so it'll be quite fun to work with. But I have to work in spots and just, I need to just keep it open. If I start to screw up with a lot of unnecessary detail and stuff and start getting neurotic, I'm really screwed. So that's very important that you kind of know your kind of limitations or whatever. Here somewhere and here about here and this one yeah this. See here. Yeah. Small town here. That. Quite fun. I think I'm going to leave it at this because I'm starting to just screw things up. It isn't really necessary for me to get everything in right now anyway. So I'll do a different way here. Yes. It's all the way down. Almost anyway. Well, just a little bit. Probably have to do some adjustments here, but you get the point. As long as I have the basic in, I can just dry a little bit and then I correct it. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, I think this sketch came out pretty nice, actually. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Live with that. So, first sketch done. That wasn't so bad, was it? Okay. Should paint that the big one. Okay, doggy dog. Put on some varnish. Like this. Oops. Okay, it wasn't totally dry. That's a problem. So, well, I did put on some very thick colors last time, so I guess that is why I haven't dried all over the place. I'm just gonna start painting because I want to. Usually I wait like 10 minutes, but today I'm gonna make an exception. Okay, I'm gonna work with this in an impressionist way. I'm not gonna go into much detail. I'm just gonna add in more light and give it some more substance. Hopefully I will be able to. It's quite difficult actually to work impressionist, especially if you do not do that usually. It's very, to me it's kind of difficult to hold back. And to choose. It's basically choosing what brushwork you want to use if you want to and go into detail, or you want to keep it open and only sketch like. No, it's not easy. I have to say, yeah, that's good. Get some red into it because it's quite red down there. So, and so. Blue. Mm-hmm. Oops. Well. So. Okay then. Just start. There, I guess, because that's the brightest part. I just need to clean up the brush a little bit. I also think I need some yellow in it, maybe some orange to heighten up the light. So like this. Really do need to clean up all my brushwork, brushes. The light. See, some yellow. Such a strong summer light. What's that sound? The outside somewhere. So I'm just gonna go all the way in this. I'm just gonna basically make it totally impression. Like this. It's actually quite yellow, but I think I also need some red in it. That was chaotic for me. Well, this is shadowing this. I would like to work on a bigger vocabulary. Maybe I should try to go all out or all in, photorealistic too. Try that, but I don't want to use a projector. That is a problem. So, maybe I'll just stick with what I do. Maybe that's best. Skomager blive den list. When you're fairly good at something, it could be a good idea just to stick with it instead of starting to screwing it up by adding in more stuff to do. Like me, I also want to play the piano, and it's not necessarily the smartest thing I can do, since I have a lot of painting to do. And there's greens here, and reds, so many different colors. Very, very strong colors in this, as you can see. I need orange or yellow, very bright. Hello. Hello. Yeah. Oi. Ja, selvfølgelig. Har han ringt meg? Hva tid kom han? Oi, han sa ikke på telefonen før nå. Ja, ja. Ja, da kom jeg. Da kom jeg. Ja, den takk så bra. Fine greier.
Oh, yeah.
So, sorry about that. He came and fetched my painting, and that was good. So now it's on its way to the exhibition. That's good. See here. Maybe that's a little bit too yellow. Kind of like this. And like this. Kind of not bright enough. I think I need to remove this. And do it again because it's too yellow. What the fuck? Okay, it's better. Okay, you can add that in afterwards. First things first. Thing is quite fun, really, because it's got a transparent shadow. Let me see now. It's blue, yellow, violet, red, very strong colors in this. Sometimes you just have to let the colors live, kind of. There, it's quite fun. It's just a shadow thrown on the wall, and it's difficult to make it actually look like a shadow on the wall. I'll do my best. I've done a kind of something similar once before. So now when you do I took these photos with Olympus digital camera, and the Olympus camera has a very, very warm type of, it's very warm, as you can see. So Okay, so I need some Prussian blue, Prussian blau in between here. Like that. I love the Prussian blue, it's a very nice color. So I like the hue. I can actually bring the colors to my home Iceland and finish some paintings there. That shouldn't be a problem, really. I would prefer to finish them here. Maybe I'm doing it a little bit too figurative now. It's kind of fun. And, there's a lot of stuff happening in there. So all these branches, how the hell am I gonna do that? You know, it's just nuts. Give myself many problems sometimes. There is a guy in my home city who is kind of specialized himself in stuff like this. But he's only kind of laying one layer down. And I think that is a little bit limited. Okay, this is his thing. But I prefer to add in a little bit more work than an impressionist thing like this, and just one layer, at least two or three. The problem, of course, is that you're killing your darlings. So when you go past that thing, there basically is no way back. That is, the first sketch is always very nice and open and stuff. Then you start painting over it like I'm doing now. And you are walking into to something a little less relative. And more problems will occur. I guess. This one too is a thing I could have done huge, because it has so many things in it, and when I do a small rendition of it like this, it's very hard to kind of give it the credit that I could if I made a bigger rendition of it, where I could actually build over time much more textures and stuff. I'll just see. Maybe I do that. I have so much to do and so little time left in existence. And I've decided to act like I'm actually going to die next year, so that I can actually focus my mind on... First of all, I have to finish a lot of unfinished business. So, to get it just out, get it out. You know, it's so draining on unfinished stuff. It is just mind-boggling, draining. Should never have a lot of stuff. Unfinished things. It's just, I mean, I can go back all the way to the beginning of the 2000. I have one huge painting, actually, of a girl called Lena. She died sadly, 27 years old, of melanoma cancer. I have an unfinished painting of her that is over 2 meters, 220, I think, or 240. I should have done it, just finished it. I should have just maybe in celebration of her, maybe. That is also something I've been thinking about for years. But it kind of, actually the painting also was about death. So it's kind of ironic. And of course I also painted in a very different way back then. So it's hard to know what to do with it. So sad, she was such a beautiful girl. Red hair, fierce, beautiful face, typical little plumper, kind of sweet. And I warned her actually so many times, because she was sunbodying too much and herself, and she was always red. Because of course she was a redhead, so she couldn't really get any color. So I didn't ever understand why the hell do you... You're gonna get skin cancer, I told her, and she bloody got it. And she died. So sad. Yeah, death is so... rootless thing. My best friend Runa died of a heart attack
That is also just surrealistic. It's just, it's very hard to comprehend when people you expect to become 300 years old, you know? The type of person that is lively and interested, and funny and everything, and he's no more. So sad.
Anyway, blah blah blah. I talk a lot about death, I know, because it kind of occupies a lot of my mind. It's actually about life. It's not so much about death, I think. It's more a reminder. Get your shit together. And in a way, you know, you see other people age and die and stuff, and but I kind of do feel that it's a slow process. But that is probably because you do never actually notice. There is not one day that you wake up and you're old. It's just a slow, incremental process. So, yeah. You wake up one morning and say, oh, I'm so old today. That's not how it works.
I don't think many people are watching these things.
I mean, if a video of mine has seen 200 times, this is kind of a miracle. So, yeah. Thank you. Really need some sleep now.
Kind of feel like I'm falling apart. That is not good.
That can't be good.
No mistakes, don't. This one. That is actually going to be like this. Let's see.
Yeah. I'm just painting and painting and forgetting that you're here. Maybe it's a good thing. Shut up. Anyway, see ya. Okie dokie dokie dokie. What was actually just going to be a nice sketch or more sketch-like painting is more and more turning into a longer, more detailed thing. And that is kind of typical, really, because there at some point you're kind of crossing that Rubicon and you just have to keep going. And yeah, so that is exactly what I'm doing, you know, just building it. That shadow is quite cool. Actually, I like that shadow. So then you go into the more detail and then it's just to keep banging on. I mean, it's just how it is, I guess. Let me see, was it kind of a wrong color? It's very important that that shadow kind of falls, gets this transparency to it. And that it kind of, it has to be a complementary color for what's in the wall. And I think that is a bluish, so some orange type of reddish thing. I think that would be the correct thing. And like this. Just gonna work a little bit around it with the white. Get it up to this. Nice when it hits that wall. And oh yeah. It's a leaf. Get really calm when I do this. I saw this documentary about this talk, actually, it's not an old podcast, about slow dopamine. And sometimes, when I do my work, I do listen to music or some noise in the background. But I would actually recommend to kind of, he said that you should sometimes do your work or your exercise or whatever without the music or without any external thing that heightens your dopamine even more. So, because when I do my work now without any music, I become very silent inside my head, very silent indeed, and I kind of I notice that things happens more calm in my head. So when I then at some point maybe put on some music, that will then enhance my dopamine even more, because it's all about dopamine. That is why it is so hard to do creative work when you are depressed. Or do the right thing, because you don't have any motivation to do it. There is nothing driving you. You just have no sense of love. You know, this intense, beautiful feeling that can actually drive you forward towards your goals. That is kind of something I was thinking about here.
because I could actually feel, when I didn't have music, I actually noticed, oh shit, I don't have any sound on at all. And it feels great, you know. So yeah, try to avoid too much things that heightens your dopamine and try to go a little bit more for the slow drip, drip, drip of dopamine. With that I mean, it's like when you drink, it is fast dopamine. Cocaine, fast training, sex, fast, porn, fast. This is slow. And this is what stabilizes my brain to a point where I really feel good. And I can't even picture life without some type of creative work or some type of thing that can actually distract me from the sheer weight of existence. Existing is not that easy, you know. We are born into, first of all, as Christopher Hitchens said, we are born into a losing struggle. And the only thing that matters is what we do in the meantime while we are kind of, when we are basically dying, you know. So, I mean, slow dopamine, the thing that gives this beautiful sense of being in a moment, way to go. Definitely way to go. So yeah. Try that. Journaling too, you know, writing a journal will really help. That brings the slow dopamine. When I manage to write, I can notice that my brain is just, the days after, is calmer, it's just in connecting with itself in a very good way. So yeah, it's good. One has to make love with the brain. Do you think about that? Right now, when I'm doing this, 100 billion neurons, 100 billion, is connected up with basically up to 30,000 links to other neurons in my brain. And together, they are playing an orchestra that creates this thing that I'm doing right now. Now, if that make you feel bored, you really shouldn't be here. Now, you know, if you can't find meaning and pleasure in that, why bother? Why are you here? That is my view on that. What's the point if you really can't see the beauty of this? I can't really understand why you should bother at all. And that's my opinion. Now I want to try to focus a little bit more on that painting here. Go in so we can actually see what I'm doing. This, type of not too much in the way. There's some blue here and some green actually, some very strong green. There's a lot of things happening down there. And it's very bright cobalt actually, for once it's cobalt blue. Which I
glad I'm using way too, not that much cobalt.
But here it is, cobalt blue. And
it's quite bright too.
Some spots in here. There's a lot of branches that crosses over. And of course, to be able to paint all these branches is just basically impossible, because there are so many of them and they are so small. But I will try to do first. I put in some thick colors here with the blue, and there are also some green here that I will want to put in, and there are some orange stuff happening. There are some lights in between. And then I will just try to use my brush to give an impression of the other things. Also some green here. Some reason there are some green. Maybe I should use the yellow. That shadow is quite strong there actually, so I'll put in that shadow. It's kind of here and like this, goes down here, but it's kind of blue also. And you have to see the wall through the shadow. I have to feel like it's a thing that it's actually hitting the wall. Now it looks more like something that is on top of it. But now I can even it out like this. And I will also cross over a little bit. See if I can make this thing come alive. It's not perfect, but you know, it's alive, it's alive. There's a very nice leaf. From a thin branch here, and this branch is so thin, but it has this leaf that kind of just falls down like this. And one deer, two. Does it? I should have had more time on this thing. And I do have, maybe I should paint them big. I need to paint this big. I need to do this perfect. Yes, that is what I need to do. There's leaves over there too. I was actually working over there. But leaf here. And there's leaves here. Coming down like this. This. Some up here. I kind of need to get these more down in. So then I this, I think, because it's wet in wet and the dark tend to mix a little bit in. Maybe other colors. Oh, it this will take some time, you know. So much happening here. So many things.
So many things, sir.
Happening. I need to start doing some huge paintings like this. Really work with landscapes. It's kind of, it's fun actually. It's giving me some
other challenges, other kind of flow.
And yeah, I have so much beautiful things to actually useful landscapes and stuff, so
should definitely start doing that. The more you paint, the more inspired you will get.
And the better you get, the more easy it gets, or if not easy, but the more you can actually do, you feel that, you know, your skills are increasing. You feel like it gives you more pleasure and stuff, so it's very nice actually. It's a nice thing to do, in my opinion. You see, is that so I have to cover this,
and I want to give that a little bit of maybe red, or is it yellow? Hard to tell.
That's how we build it. A little bit chaotic. It is chaotic, but I have to make it chaotic in the right way. You know, the things has to have address, and that's difficult when there's so much happening in a painting like this. If you are working bigger, and you can actually add and subtract much more. This painting or this photo. It's basically almost like a relief in its color and its intensity. It is already a relief. You see that? It is just crazy. It's just crazy. There's some plants coming in here. That's nice because they actually give it a little bit extra. Makes it a little bit yellow down here and also underneath here. And goes a little bit up like this and like this. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. I think it's becoming quite nice. Is it just, it's just a bath of light? Okay. It's called a bath of light. Yeah, that's what it is. The light. It's much more brighter underneath there with that. Like that. Mm-hmm.
Memento mori, remember you're going to die. Do the best you can while you have time to do it. And you get a drive of so much pleasure from it also. The pleasure of finished work, you shouldn't underestimate that at all. It is probably one of the best feelings you can have. Good works, the best. The best of the best. See that sky between that thing. And there's this branch just cutting right through it. Just the branch a little bit. A little bit thicker. So now I'm really going into this manic detail thing, and of course that will cost a few extra hours on it. Problem is that you also start seeing all the small mistakes you did, and then I start trying to fix it, and like that branch is just not there, it is higher up. I just have to pretend I have kind of kneeled down a little bit. Okay, like that. Okay. That better? Yeah, I think so. I think so. Yes, I do. Now, there's some leaves just hanging around, crossing over. Some leaves here, hanging around. Leaves here, here. Stuff. There's one going right up. There's one coming down. There's one here, there's one coming out here. Yeah, something like that. Getting it here. Underneath here, something happening. So you see, there's a lot of stuff happening here. This one is coming down.
Thanks for that. Sun is actually hitting that branch. A little more yellow, actually. So, and it goes up here. And it's here. There. And here. There. Something is happening up here too. So much happening in there. It's just chaotic things, piece of light, and down here too. Underneath, that actually is more yellow, way more yellow. Yeah, and this one too. That's why, probably because of the blue. There are branches coming here, crossing over this one. There are branches here. You know, now it's the kind of thick colors, and I just add them into the thick color, mixing them basically together. And you know, it's a lot of stuff happening. There's one coming in here, goes all the way here, goes all the way up like this. So much happening. Just goes right down. Oh, yeah. I think this is kind of turning out a little bit nice. What do you think? Well, that was a half an hour, so we're just gonna paint some more and then call it a day, I think, because I can't keep on doing this forever. Anyway. Okay, so I am now going to do just a tiny bit more and I'm gonna call it, because it is time, to put it mildly. There's always another brushwork, another stage. Always something more you can do. Especially with a thing like this that I've now turned into a way more complex thing than I actually planned for. But I also enjoy it, so I guess I just have to get some of these branches in. There's so many things happening. I am gonna paint some of these in bigger renditions. I just have to.
because they are so challenging
and they are so massively sculptural that will actually really having me push myself to the limit when it comes to my painting skills and stuff. So yeah, I think that is a very good way to think about this. I just wanna, you see, I work kind of in between. To think about this, you start painting on something like this, you do a, if it's a big painting, you do a very fairly good sketch, open sketch, then you start to mold it and start to see all the small mistakes that you have done. Then you start to add abstract, you start to add new things, you start, you know, let's just keep on banging on, and in the end you will have built such a beautiful thing. Because of all the overpaint and all the adjustments, it comes with the territory. There's a window here with a lot of red in it because it's a kind of a low sun. I like the roof. There's a spot of yellow, it's a thick spot here and here. That's how you build . So, put in some branches. Here. There's a lot of stuff happening here, you know. So many things happening. I can't possibly bring them in all, so I just have to. Stop at some point where I can do this for 10 days or something like that. Never ending story, basically. Some sunlight hitting the branch. And a little bit of chaos. brain is just going so silent. I think that is it is what made me keep painting, that silence, this deep silence I get, which is basically, it's basically one of the few things that can actually give me that silence. And a lot of the driving force comes from that. Spots. I remember I saw a documentary about Lucian Freud. He was kind of doing things in spots and kind of added in, almost like he did a whole thing in small parts. It's quite quite intense to look at. He died right after a video, actually. It's strange to think about. This painting, boom, that was dead. That happens to us all, of course. Yeah, I talk too much about death, I know. Maybe I should stop. People are getting depressed. They don't want to hear it. It's like the abuse of children. People don't want to hear about it. But sorry, it's there. It's just a part of reality. It sucks. Really sucks. So yeah, it's horrible. The horror. We shouldn't die. And we shouldn't abuse children. I mean, human consciousness is the most important thing in the universe. There's nothing. Nothing as we know of, anyway. And I would claim that even if we knew about something even more conscious, I mean, our consciousness would be the center for us anyway. So yeah, okay, there's one going up there. I do hope you get something out of this, and that you give it a thumbs up and leave a comment and stuff. I would be really grateful for that. It really helps me algorithm and inspire me to make more videos. It takes time, but it's also nice to document your work. For, as I talked about yesterday or what day it was, now filming the work is like prolonging your life. Every time somebody sees the video, and that is the truth, I wasn't thinking about it in that way before. Every time somebody sees one of these videos, they are watching time. They are watching, they are prolonging my time in existence, in a way. And yeah, what more could it there be? I think that was the last poof.
and I do think I can say I'm a little bit pleased with it. I noticed that this fence is a bit more greenish in reality. So I'll do that. Just do like this. Because there, this is kind of in the dark, so I just have to keep it down. There's a little bit of light hitting over here also, and here actually, and here there's a bright light here. There, sunlight, yes. And now you see, it just takes over. All the time this happens, it just takes over and starts living its own life. So sometimes it's quite frustrating actually. Because in a painting like this, as I say, there is an infinite amount of things. Not infinite, but it's a lot of shit happening. And I can, in theory, just keep banging on. Forever. So, last touch. These things will be so wet when you hang on the wall. Tear myself away from it now. It's really difficult to tear myself away. Ooh. Almost a little bit supernatural. I just can't tear myself apart. Tear myself away, I mean, sorry. Yes. Yeah, this one actually goes all the way up there. So, but there's also a little bit of red. You
See, now this is a, this is impressionism
in action, definitely.
Maybe I screw up here a little bit.
Maybe I just need to put in some yellow and leave it.
Yeah. That would be a very good plan, actually. It has this thing, round thing here.
It annoys me that I haven't painted. Now I go so deep into detail that, you know.
You basically just could start redo the whole thing. That's called, that's what is having a manic personality. You really have problems tearing yourself away from stuff. And things take an enormous amount
of importance, things that doesn't really...
Things that aren't that really that important takes the form of the most important thing in the world, and right now it's the small spots of light down here, and it's kind of ridiculous, you know.
So in an objective sense,
so, I think this will be it. Yes. Let's tone this down a little bit. That is where this signature is supposed to be. Okay.
I will only sign this with my initials.
Some more branches, maybe. Thank you. just can't do it anymore now.
So, I'm going to sign it with some red color so it's easy to see my signature.
Then I just sign it K. No.
Blue. I think that's better. Cobalt blue. Some white maybe.
Okay.
Yeah, I need some more white.
Okay. A. V. Zero. One.
That's it. That's it, my friends. Yeah. Cannot possibly do anything more now. Except from a little bit all over the place. Until I drop dead by exhaustion. I do think this should stay alone now. Okay, done, fini. Whew. Okay, put the frame on and show you the painting. I do think it came out pretty nice. It's not that bad. Perfect, but not that bad. Small discrepancies, but you know, that's life. Yay. And voila, here is the finished painting, and it came out, yeah, I don't know. I also did change the signature because it was too low for the frame. And I did it in red. Then I lost it on the floor. And it became full of sand. So I needed to get all the sand out. And it also smashed in some of the high levels of paint. So I needed to do a lot of work on that too. So shit happens. Now it's really smart to have a clean floor. So you don't fill of stones and stuff. But anyway, this is how it turned out. I think it became quite nice. So with this, I hope you give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, tell me what you think. Should I do more of these? Is it nice to watch or do you learn something? Please tell me. And if you want to support my channel, go to PATRON and sign up for $1 or $5. I actually do a giveaway every month, a painting about this size, and can be anything, can be like this, it can be a still life, can be a portrait, can be anything. So sign up for $5. For $15 I will actually teach you how to paint by webcam, and also teach you, if you give a $5, I will just help you. So with this, stay cool, keep painting, and see.